Our next speaker is Valentina Alberti. Her scientific education is astrophysics, and she has graduated from the University of Trieste in Italy and worked at the Astronomical Observatory in the field of space weather. So, to explain that a bit, in particular, she was studying the interaction between solar radio bursts and GPS receivers. Since 2 years, she's part of the Telescope Manager Consortium of the Square Kilometer Array, in short SKA, and she's collaborating in applying a user-centered design to the development of the user interfaces of the control of SKA. Please.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody. Professor Brynick and I have been tasked to support the development of the user interfaces for the control room of the Square Kilometer Array. And what I'm going to show you today are some possible recommendations for the developers that have been understood using a user-centered design approach. So, SKA is going to be the largest radio telescope in the world. In the first phase, it will comprise 200 dishes that will be built in South Africa in a radio quiet zone, and 512 stations of 2,056 dipolar antennas that will be located in Australia. The amount of expected raw data is huge. How will it work? So the signal from the receptor will be correlated by a correlator of each telescope. This will produce the building blocks that will be further processed by the signal data processor to produce the final scientific products. As you can imagine, a system like this, an operator who has to run a system like this, will have to be able to process a huge amount of information. So it is very important to be able to support him during his work. So we decided to adopt a user-centered design approach in order to be able to understand which are the tasks of the operator and if there are some features that could help in running the telescopes. This would also prevent the development of bottom-up developed user interfaces, which will be probably being great to represent the system, but will fail to help the operator in doing his job. And this could lead to loss of observational time, poor qualities of scientific data, damages to the system, and so on. So the user-centered design approach is a set of techniques. We use some of them to create, for example, profiling, scenarios, task models, and sketches and storyboards for SKA. But what I'm going to show you today is a direct result of interview people from two other telescopes and to organize the observation using affinity diagram techniques. So, we conducted the semi-structured interviews at LOFAR at Mercat. LOFAR is a telescope that is currently producing high-quality data science. It is fully operational, while Mercat is a telescope that is currently in the construction phase, which means that new receptors, new software, new devices are being built and added to the system as soon as they are ready. The interviews have been done during field trips in 2016 and have been conducted with some goals in mind. These goals was to understand which are the roles that can be played in the control room, which are the relationships among these roles, what are the procedures that are followed, for example, when dealing with alarms, what are the operator's tasks, and if there are some strengths and weaknesses of the actual in-use user interfaces. So the information that we collected using paper notes have been clustered and reclustered by the interviewers, and in order to understand, to organize the information that we collected. We created a small cluster of 3-4 nodes each that was very concentrated to particular topics. The roles of the people we interviewed are listed there. There are not only operators, but also scientists and software people. And this is because they all collaborate in the maintaining the observatory, the telescope, in good running condition or in understanding the quality of the data that are produced. Some of the categories in of the clusters was shared by the two telescopes. For example, we both time we had a consideration about the user interfaces. So, some results from the organization of information that we have made using affinity diagrams are detailed information about the profiles, the user profiles. Here we are. There are some points regarding the operator. They work in quiet control rooms with a high rate of visual input, several keywords and mice that could lead sometimes to errors because sometimes they use the wrong mice, for example, to do what they want to do. The overall job is to conduct a successful observation, to grant safety and to avoid damages to the system. So they feel like they have high responsibility tasks. And this could sometimes lead to stressful situation in case of high alarms rate, for example. Some design objectives have been highlighted, and they are the reliability of the interactions, which means that the user interface should show the needed information in a very clear and unambiguous manner. That's because operators' nature is to dig down to the detail every time they see something that could be wrong. So they will possibly lose time in looking for wrong messages that are due to the user interface and doesn't come from the system. The completeness, operators should be able to develop situation awareness, and there should be some tolerance against errors. For example, if the operator can do some action that could affect the system, confirmation should be asked. An important point is that operators see observations, devices, and processes as very related entities. So the user interface should be able to support this relationship. For example, if they have to diagnose a problem in a hardware, they want to know which are the processes using this hardware and which are the possibly affected observations. So some other considerations are about possible problems, usability problems for SKA. One of these is fragmentation, which means that the lack of integration between different UI components. This is an example we took from LOFAR. It gives you an idea of the layout of the control room used there. The problem here is that they are using three different systems to monitor antenna and devices, to monitor the network, and to monitor the status of the observations. This could lead to low usability because different tools have different behaviors. For example, they have different look and feel, different method for navigation, different notification method, and the operator have to continuously switch from one to the other one in order to understand the information that he is seeing. This is frustrating for the operator and requires them to have a higher mental load and to be less effective in doing their tasks. Another problem that will arise for SKA is scalability. Scalability has to deal with the ability of the UI to adapt to the amount of information and to show different scales of the system. SKA, as we have seen, the amount of information will be huge. This is an example we took for Meerkat, where the receptors are represented with this circle, and the slices in the circle are the devices. They are color-coded to show the status of the devices and of the receptor itself. And this representation is actually very effective, both to give quick idea of the status of the system and to attract the operation attention. But if we scale the screen to 200 dishes, this will probably be just confusing. Moreover, we have no information about the position of the antenna in the array, for example, but this could be useful for the operator, for example, to relate some possible faults. An example is if there is a power failure that could interest more than one receptor, for example. Another example are these two monitor here. They are really, really useful for operators because operators are able to understand a lot looking at these monitors. But again, the first one will not scale for 200 dishes. It represents the result of correlation for each baseline. And the number of baselines grows as the number of receptors squared divided by 2. So this would be useless in the case of SKA. We really need to understand how to show this information probably when it is requested and not all the time for each receptor. The second plot shows the signal incoming to the receptor received by the receptor, and again it is very useful for operator because they can understand if the receiver is working properly. But in this case we have a problem which is related to our visual system. Our short term visual memory has a low capacity, so we are able to retain only a few information from one fixation to the next one, which means that an operator will keep looking at the lines and the legend to understand which lines describe which receptor. Another problem that have to be taken into account is the ability to extend the user interface with new functionalities, new toolbar, new tabs. This is because, for example, for SKA, the system will operate for 20, 15 years, and we can't assume that everything will stay the same in such a long period. So the designer have to keep it in mind when designing the user interface. Another point are gaps. There are features that are felt as needed by the operators, but that are missing in the user interface. This could be a problem because operators are skilled people in programming and scripting, and they will be tempted to develop their own part of the user interface. But this will probably be difficult to maintain in time and will be probably used only by the person that developed it. Moreover, if there is a gap, it means that the user needs are not completely covered by the user interface. So a very careful analysis of the task that operators have to accomplish is needed for SKA. So concluding, using a user-centered design approach helped us to identify what are the tasks of the operator and what are the possible features that can help him and possible difficulties, possible problems that could arise and lead to low usability in the case of SKA. Because we use this method and this problem have been already identified, probably the risk that developing suboptimal interfaces is reduced. But of course the designers will have to take into account this point. So this is the last line, and if you want to contact us, these are our email addresses.
Thank you very much for this general conversation on user experience. Do we have questions?
I had a question. I always have a question. Now, what is the next step? I mean.
Okay, the next step is to go ahead with this approach, develop more scenarios, more sketches, more storyboards to be used to test the possible feature with the users, and give as much as possible material for the developers to take the right path. Okay.
I don't see more questions, so thanks again. Oh, sorry, there is in the
I was wondering how big your design and development teams are that are working on this project.
At the moment, we are two person dealing with this kind of approach. The subsystem are working on their own user interfaces, but at some point we will have to involve designers and people with high skills in the field to develop the whole user interface. These are just the starting points, if you want.
Okay. Okay, then, thanks again.